Aye, they're definitely around here somewhere. I remember I put them here last night. This is just ridiculous.
Has anybody here seen my food? I left a gluten-free cereal bar, some quail's eggs, and beef paste sandwiches down there with a crust cut off. Hey? Oh, Shabazz! Welcome, my friends, to Big Brother's Little Brother, Stage 7. And the time is 7:29. Before we go any further, stop the applause, ladies and gentlemen, because a little light went out in Little Brother's studio last night. It was one of the most talked-about housemates in Big Brother history slipped quietly out of the back door. Can I get an R? Aww. A moment's silence, if you please. No one a party for the spirit to in a BBLB world exclusive is here to tell us his story and answer your questions in today's cool BBLB. Details should be on the screen right now. How exciting. Listen, that's exciting, but this is even more exciting. Hold on to your hats, hold on to your cutlery and place any broken timepieces next to the screen. The one, the only, Uri Geller's with us today, ladies and gentlemen. There he is, currently bending the housemates' minds. He's already bent three cameramen who'll be reporting back to us later on in the show. Watching him, he's in our inner circle. Before all of that, we get a reality check as we kick off the show, as we always do, my friends. We wouldn't have it any other way. With Little Brother's big news. Hello there. So anyway, listen. He wanted to go, then he wanted to stay, then he wanted to go again, then he wanted to stay again, and finally, at 7:55 last night, Shabazz decided to take his final bow. Take a look.
Do you have any final words that you wish to say to your fellow housemates?
Yes. I wish them the best of luck. But I have to go because I can't be false with people.
Shabazz has left the Big Brother house, so will not be returning.
Seriously? All right.
I wish him all the best out there.
Sorry, we didn't do anything wrong. We
have to. Someone will pack his. They'll give us the
and
suitcase.
And then we'll put it in the store.
I'll do it because he's my bedmate, so I'll do it.
Yeah.
I'll do it.
For only the second time this series, I think that warrants a double clutch. Now then, move over, Mikey and Caesar. There's a new hunk in town. At 10:59 this morning, a self-proclaimed Welsh boy beautiful that is Glenn underwent a major image overhaul. Let's take a look.
Good, what do you think? It's better, isn't it?
Much better.
Now he's going to be like a hot stud. You happy with that then? He's a stud now. Ooh. A Welsh stud. He's going to bag himself a nice hot Welsh lady.
How's look?
Pah! Short hair's rubbish on boys. And here is the hair, and we were playing around with it in rehearsal. I'm sure we'll be giving it away very soon. And actually, it's a lot like snuff. And listen, lastly, 7 days without her cleansers, exfoliators and oatmeal scrubs seem to be taking a toll on the former Miss Wales. At 4:06 this afternoon, this happened.
Whiteheads, you should really just pop the top of it and press it out. Not squeeze it till it bursts. You have to press it out. Otherwise the infection spreads under the skin.
Firstly, quite disgusting to see Imogen squeezing her spots in front of the mirror. But secondly, even more worrying to see the psychotic look that Nikki gave her. Can we have another look at that, as we can see here? Who do you think you are? Coming in here in this house, squeezing your spots. Oh, I'll show you. Just after I straighten me hair. And that, my friends, was... Hang on a second. It appears the pass phone's ringing. Hello there, what? Was that another snog? Who was it? Never. Well, can I tell the BBLV viewers? No, Are you telling me they'll have to tune in tonight, 9 o'clock on Channel 4 to watch?
Oh, stop calling me at work.
That was Little Brother's Big News. Funny old news today. So, interesting. The Big Brotherhood is finished. It is deceased. It is an ex-task. Yesterday, we reported that Lisa Shabazz, Pete, Grace, Richard and Caesar were all in the Brotherhood. Since then, Shabazz has left. Can I get an R? Mikey, however, has taken his place as the leader and chosen George to join him. There you go, gorgeous George. So, that left Bonnie, Dawn, Imogen, back, and Nikki, and Glyn. Where's Glyn? Lovely. OK, then, at 4:41 this afternoon, this happened.
Right, we'd like Nikki to join our brotherhood because I think she's lively, she's entertaining, she's got a brilliant character, she's so truthful, and she's just like a little burst of energy. And when I see that smile, she's lovely.
Lisa!
Thank you!
Imogen, because she's just so sweet and she just, like, she's into joining in and, like, she's just so nice.
I'm gonna go.
No! My brain's exploding. We'll keep you updated as and when it happens. So, Nikki and Imogen are safe, which means... Got a couple of blackheads there, which means Bonnie, Dawn and Glyn are not in the Brotherhood and therefore up for eviction. One of them's going to leave on Friday. Who's it going to be? Is up to you. Lines are open. Start from now. And remember, the two housemates that remain will do so without the suitcases for possibly the whole summer, if Big Brother wants a revolution on its hands. After 127 hours and 45 minutes of televisual incarceration in the Big Brother house, Shabazz decided to throw in the towel. Well, actually, it was Leah's towel. And resigned from his role as the nation's favourite berry-wearing snack snatcher. Did he go out in a blaze of glory? No, he went out the fire exit.
I love my mouth. Look at that. I mean, you can't buy lips like that.
Everybody's so cool.
Shabazz is Joan
Crawford.
I beg you to forgive me because I made a terrible mistake just with ego.
Unless I get some straight answers, I'm walking.
She's the only one that's giving you time.
Leave
to... They're just not getting it. And that's a shame.
Oh, you're done with me.
I hate disappointing people.
Big Brother is in no way disappointed, Shabazz.
Then please let me go.
Somewhere over the rainbow, bluebirds fly. Birds fly over the rainbow. Then oh, why can't I?
Now then. If I say the magic word shebang after three and you want him to appear, he will appear. Should we all do it together? One, two, three. Shebang!
May I sit down?
Sit down, Shabazz.
Thank you. You're very kind. Hi, Dermot.
How are you?
So beautiful in real life.
It's nice to see you too, Shabazz.
Nice to see you
but
too.
Let's get cracking on this interview. And I don't want a performance, I want the real you.
Do you know what you mean you don't want? Okay.
24 hours to reflect on the whole experience. How are you feeling?
I quit while I was ahead, Dermot. I had no choice, actually. Can I relax, please?
Of course you can.
Thank you.
Extrapolate on that.
Well, I went in and everybody had been. From what I gather from my fellow housemates, I probably had a very good celebration of an entrance, and I was really, if you saw the way I looked, I was awestruck.
Yeah.
And it lasted 4 days, and then I fell apart.
Mm-hmm.
But if I'm really honest with you, I'm still a bit... I found it quite stifling, I have to be honest. But What I did have to say about it is I was part of the Brotherhood and I was immune from eviction.
Mm-hmm.
And I wasn't nominated, and I thought, quit while you're ahead.
Well, those were all very positive things there, but when you went in, did you...
I never saw my breakdown coming. Wasn't it spectacular, everyone?
Well, it was. I've got to be honest with you, it was spectacular, but it was...
Crash television at its finest, everybody.
No, but Siobhan, seriously, it was quite disturbing to watch, and...
I am disturbed, Dermot.
No, but it was quite disturbing to watch, and you know, did you have a game plan when you first went in there?
I know, I always said... Excuse me, Dermot. One had always said, I would play it by ear.
Mm-hmm.
But I never saw this one coming. I'll tell you, everybody, I didn't.
OK, here's what you said before you went in.
I personally feel, I mean, I'm not up myself in any way. I'd like to think I'm really down to earth.
Hopefully, making allowances. Maybe I'll make a nice friend.
But I'm a very caring person.
I try and be my most tolerant, objective self, which can be done.
I'd like them to see to the goodness of my heart. So I promised myself before I got to 40 I would calm down. And if you can't let it go, like water off a duck's back, then you're not going to survive.
See, this is interesting. Now what happened? Because there you seem very positive. I think it's safe to say you were quite antagonistic in the house.
Dermot, I never saw what I saw in the mirrors of the Big Brother house. It's been the most magical, mystical Wizard of Oz ride of my life.
In what way?
The only thing I saw in the mirrors was not Big Brother. I saw all my demons from my past come back and bite me in the ass, and I had to face them all.
Mm-hmm.
And it was very difficult.
Of course it was. But do you see it as a... Now you've come out, because obviously you found it very difficult to relate to the people who were in there.
Please believe me, they're all individually wonderful, but they didn't expect me to fall apart the way I did, and I didn't expect to fall apart the way I did.
So do you feel bad about how you were with them?
Very.
OK. And in terms of how what you've learned from the house, it's been a cathartic experience. Do you think?
Very.
Because I was watching yesterday, and you said when you were in the pool, you said this is that I've been reborn. And
yes.
Explain that to us.
Well, you're not going to believe this, but because of everything I had been through in my childhood,
right
through to adulthood, homelessness, starvation, sexual abuse, molestation, and the rest. And ostracization. I spectacularly fell apart.
Yes, but what happened in the pool?
Well, when you said you reborn, day, I jumped in, and believe it or not, I'm a Pisces, and I've always been afraid of deep water.
It's not particularly deep, though, so you don't need to worry.
That's why I didn't have to worry. But I jumped.
Go on,
but
you
I jumped in, and at the bottom of the pool, I saw my reflection. And the sun was blazing down, and I looked absolutely beautiful, and I thought, Shabazz, you can survive now.
OK, and then you decided that was enough.
That was enough. You can walk away now.
OK, one particular housemate stood by through thick and thin was Pete. I want to talk about your friendship in just a second, but let's take a look at him.
At first, I thought, oh, no, but it's like, oh, it's all right. He's looking after me. He's bringing me everything. It's like mother role, and that's all right, you know?
I see, you are an odd, extreme character.
And
some people they get uncomfortable with it, but I don't.
I wouldn't want him to leave the house purely because he's a source of entertainment.
Part of me, I want to look after you. That makes sense, because I'm thinking, well, I'm the oldest person here, and no matter what, you're younger than me, and I want to look after you.
I feel
a bit sad for Shabazz.
I didn't know how to stick up for him, really, because he kept on shooting himself in the foot.
See, you know, I know you're quite emotional watching that, but it's interesting to see, like you said, individually, you got on with people to start with. It's just that, you know, as it went on. I'm sorry, I'm going to have to just to wrap up. How did you feel about the whole experience?
I owe...
Come on, Shabazz.
I owe Big Brother a whole new lease of life. It has been the most cathartic. I have waited a lifetime of abuse to feel alive again.
OK. Shabazz, thank you so much. It's taken a lot of bravery coming on today, so appreciate it. Well done. OK, Shabazz is back to answer your questions later on in the show, and Yuri Geller is on his way back from the camera run. There's no wind outside. That wind has just been created by Geller, the presence. We'll sing what indeed the housemates are thinking later on, and you'll really want to hear what he has to say. We'll see you in three. Hello, welcome back to Space 7. Time is
7:49. We've got some stuff to get through. Let's get going.
Shabazz is going to be back later on for Cool BBLB. Right now, joining me is someone who not only knows what's going on inside the house, but knows what's going on inside the housemates' minds. You're really going to love this. It's Yuri Geller, everyone.
Hey. Yuri, it's lovely to see you. How are you?
Nice to have you back with us. Yuri, OK, first up, what do you make of this year's housemates?
I love it. The mixture is fantastic. The different personalities and characters. You just don't know what's going to happen.
OK. A favourite housemate of yours so far, Yuri? And who's your favourite?
It would have to be Pete.
OK.
Because, you know, beside his condition, he's very open, natural. He's entertaining. He's fascinating,
yes.
too. There's something about him that he uses his charisma and his natural charm to captivate the audience.
Did you pick up on anything when you were in the camera runs, when you were looking at...
Look, let's face it, everyone wants to win.
Mm-hmm.
You know, there is that burning desire to, I'm going to win, it's going to be me. And most of them are not playing to camera, they're settled into the house and they're who they are.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Is there anything you've picked up that we couldn't have picked up? You think that you'd some insight you'd like to give us?
Or... Well, I actually focused on Bonnie, and she's very concerned that she somewhere knows that she might be going next.
Mm-hmm.
I definitely picked up stress, anxiety. You know, you're in there.
From Bonnie or from everyone?
From everyone.
Okay, yeah, well, it's been
almost everyone.
A traumatic time.
Yeah.
Okay, there's a housemate you're not so keen on, though, is that right? You don't like...
Yeah, you know, Lisa, I'm very much against smoking and smokers, and she's like chain smoking and she's polluting the air. I mean, isn't she the only one who's smoking in there?
I'm not entirely sure about the smoking.
Yeah, but she's also so unpredictable, and she comes, I mean, in my opinion, you know.
Of course.
She's sort of my person that I don't hate anyone, but if I'd have to choose from all of them, she would be the one that I sort of dislike the most.
Okay, so the weirdest thing is that Lisa and Pete actually are getting on very well.
I don't believe that.
Let's take a look.
I don't believe that.
Oh, it's really good that, what's her name again? Lisa. I'm really glad she's here. She has that certain spark that I like in people.
Yeah, mate, Ricky, like, I mean, wow!
Pete, I like him. He's mint. It's funny.
None of our laughs today as well, haven't we?
She really gets me going. She gets my juices flowing. Where has she been all my life?
I think there's a future for them. You think...
No, I don't think so. Okay,
oh,
that's my
opinion. That's the dreams.
You know, yeah, well, who knows? But I'm very rarely wrong.
Okay. Now, you spent some time in the camera runs. Any ideas as to what they're thinking right now?
Right now? They all want to win. I'm actually sorry that Shabazz left.
Mm-hmm.
Because he was... What a character. I mean, he's... In my opinion, a star.
How could you have, if you were in the camera, the only way you could have challenged the energy to try and get him to stay?
Sure, look, I only had about 10 minutes behind the glass.
Sure.
But I could actually feel that I'm connecting to, especially to one or two people in particular. Maybe next time I'll come back, you ask me to do something and we'll focus.
No, absolutely. But who in particular were you connected with?
Pete.
You gesticulated.
Definitely Pete and... Nikki, you know, Nikki is also amazing.
Okay.
There is that naivety about her. She's sort of gullible, but she's sharp and she's pretty. And yeah, do you want to know who's going to win?
I want to know who's going to leave this Friday first, and then I want to know who's going to
win. Okay, I think that the person who's going to leave will be Bonnie.
Mm-hmm.
But again, Glenn, by the way, you know the hair that you have in that box that belongs to Glenn.
You can put
that on eBay and get £5,000-£10,000 for.
We're keeping it. It's priceless.
Yeah.
And lastly, who do you think is going to win, Yuri?
I think Nikki.
Interesting.
Yeah. Well, who do you think is going to win?
I don't know.
Come on, I changed every day. You have to make a guess.
I go for the grey man. I think. And weirdly, if you want this from me, no. I think Grace might come around and snatch it at the last.
You think so?
Yeah.
No.
Yuri Geller, everyone.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So, the first eviction's only 50 hours away. Either Bonnie, Dawn or Glyn's going to be leaving on Friday. No doubt you're already planning your buffet spread and thawing out your prawn rings. But your party would not be complete without us. BBLB want to come to your eviction party, so please invite us. Go on, be best friend by sending a video of you in your house explaining what we've got to look forward to. Here's how you get in touch. OK, it's time for today's cool BBLB, which could only be asked of Baz. Yuri, you want to say something first, all right?
I want to say that this guy is a star, and I'm bewildered and amazed and astonished that he's not an entertainer. I want to be his agent.
OK.
Well, he's unbelievable. And I'll tell you what, my prediction is going to go far. He's going to have his own television show.
OK, thank you very much. Let's get to the cool straight away. Paul in Leicester. Hello, Paul.
Hi, Dermot.
How you doing? All right?
Hi.
Go for it.
Hi, Shabazz. Hi. You were one of the biggest personalities in the house whilst you were there. How do you think the group will develop now without you?
How do you think the group's going to develop without you?
Well, I've got to be really honest. Didn't Richard just want to be the only gay in the Big Brother village? So, didn't he just?
Well,
he is Glinda, and they portrayed me as the Wicked Witch of the one with the. But I had the ruby slipper, so I knew it was time to go,
so
and
you,
I didn't give them up.
You think Richard's going to carry on being the daddy of the house?
I don't particularly care what role he takes.
OK, let's try and get one more caller, Tony in Aylesbury. Hello, Tony.
Hello, Dermot.
Go for it.
Hi, Shabazz. You were great in the house, by the way, mate. Now you've had a chance to reflect, what would you say has been your favourite moment in the house?
Very briefly.
In the house, I loved walking in, but in the house, when they played me Kylie.
Wonderful. There we go. wonderful.
And Helium.
Kylie and Helium, a winning combination. Thank you very much. That's all we've got time for. Thanks, Shabazz, you and all the callers. Big one tonight, 9 o'clock, Channel 4, Russell at 10 o'clock on E4. See you tomorrow. Take care, bye-bye.